Hi, hello, good morning, namaste. Welcome to SBR, the temple of knowledge and wisdom. This is Siddhamma Kalshetty, faculty of English. Students, I hope so. You might have watched my previous session videos, all the videos. If not it, don't worry. Just go to YouTube channel and subscribe SBR online classes. And right here you can watch the videos. So today I'm going to deal with the class. You can see on the board I have written and have pasted some pictures, beautiful pictures on the wall, or you can say the board. You can recognize easily which lesson I'm gonna deal with today. Students, my today's topic is Two Gentlemen of Verona, written by A.J. Cronin. So, I have pasted here five pictures. You can see there, even this picture you can recognize as Cronin, okay? The writer, the author of the story, Cronin. And these are two boys' characters you can see on the board. They are the characters of this story, okay? Whom I'm gonna say, Two Gentlemen of Verona. And you can see the two more pictures here. Two boys and the car is over there. And there is a boy who is polishing shoe, and two boys, and they are selling foods as well as polishing shoes and all, okay? These are just pictures, and today I'm gonna just start the lesson that is called Two Gentlemen of... Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm back here. So, I'm gonna start the story, Two Gentlemen of Verona, written by A.J. Cronin. A.J. Cronin was a Scottish novelist. Students, he was belonged to Scotland. He was a Scottish novelist and a physician whose works combining realism with social criticism. He was not only a novelist, he was a great physician also. So being physician, he wrote many books, many novels and all. He won realism and social criticism when a large Anglo-American readers. So Anglo-American readers, there were many readers, there were many followers of him. Many people used to watch his, you know, even movies are there. His movies also you can watch on YouTube, okay? YouTube movies as well as books, stories and novels, many things he has written. And let me talk about his birth, students. His birth, he had born on 19th July 1896 in Scotland. 19th July. And his death, yeah, he is no more, students. So his death was on Jan 6th, okay? Jan 6th, 1981, Switzerland. So award, he has even won the award of, for his work, students. Can see on the board here, I have written award for National Books Award for fictions. He has written fictions and all. He has won, or you can say he had won national level award, National Book Award for his fictions. Even you can see here his best books I have written about. His best books or novels for a well-known novel, you can see The Citadel Tells a Scottish Doctor in a Welsh Mining Village. It published in 1937. This is about our beloved writer, A.J. Cronin. You can see here in the picture. He is A.J. Cronin, students. So, even I can say something. This story, if you are CBC students, if you are CBC student, even state syllabus, am I right? Yeah, state syllabus also. You have studied the story, Two Gentlemen of Verona. This story you have studied in your school also. So same story is there. You are very familiar with this story. Once again, you are going to study because it is really good story. And you can tell me, ma'am, why this PUC board has selected the same story once again, though we have studied in school, that is CBSE school or PU school, why once again PU board has selected this story for us? Let me tell you, students, this story is a fantastic story which each and everybody, they ought to be followed this story, they, especially these characters. The writer wants to tell or convey the message that though being a human being, sometimes being a human being, we forget what we are. We don't even, you know, help others. We don't even follow the society rules. We forget everything. We think we are really great and we are everything. We live our own life. We don't even bother the other people. But being a true human being, we should be a gentleman also. We should be a gentleman also. Especially PU students, it is your turning life, a turning point of your life. You should not only study, not only focus on studies, even you have to focus on your responsibilities also. Okay, responsibilities towards your family, towards the society, towards your friends. This story tells you how to lead a life. This story tells you how to be, you know, succeed in the life. And even this story tells you, though you earn little, how can you live a peaceful life or happy life? How can we prove we are the true gentleman? This is a story written by Eugene Tony. Now, let me start the story. And before starting the story, students, you can see here in your textbook, pre-reading activity is there. Okay? In your textbook, Reflection English textbook, PUC first year, page number 101. So in this story, two gentlemen fell. Before starting the story, I want to read something that is called pre-reading activity. What is this pre-reading activity? Why each and every story has this, students? This is nothing. Pre-reading activity means it connects, it gives a just, you know, glimpse or link of the chapter. Okay, a glimpse or a link to the chapter which you are going to study. It gives just a glimpse or you can say a link to the chapter which you are going to study. So that is called pre-reading activity. Once you read this, then it can connect easily towards the story which you are going to study. So here there is a question for you. What word or phrase come to your mind when you think of the quality of a gentleman? What word or phrase come to your mind when you think of a quality of a gentleman? Yes, students, come on, tell me. When I say gentleman, what quality or thought comes to your mind? Yeah, obviously, you may say, ma'am, a good-looking person, ma'am. Yes, I agree. Ma'am, a handsome person, ma'am. Okay, I agree. Even you can say, ma'am, well-dressed, or else, you know, it has given here. The courtiers, or else, for instance, well-spoken person. Yeah, obviously, students. It may be well-spoken person, well-dressed person, a good-looking person, or educated person, anything. But rather than this, even we can call the gentleman person a person who has good qualities. A person who has good qualities. A person who knows, irrespective of age, how to work in the society, how to lead a happy life, how to earn money, how to respect others, how to help others. Even that is very important. Okay, irrespective of age. We cannot even say, ma'am, a person who is elder one, for him or her, we can say gentleman. No, lady or gentleman, who students? Irrespective of age, if a boy of a 10-year or 12-year or 13-year-old, if he has the qualities of gentleman, we can salute and say him, your gentleman. In this story also, we are going to study two characters, Nicola and Jacopo. Nicola and Jacopo, two stories are, two characters are there. These two are, you can see on the board. I tried my level best to paste it because I'm not a good painter. That's the reason. These two characters, Nicola and Jacopo. Even here also you can see Nicola and Jacopo. These two are the brothers in the story, students. I'll let you know clearly in detail the story. So first, let me describe the characters of the story. Why do we call these two children gentlemen? What's the reason behind it? What they have done, such a great thing. Okay, everything I'll let you know in the story now. Students, as I said, you, when the thought comes in your mind, gentlemen, then this may say, for instance, a good-looking person, well-spoken person, well-dressed person. Okay, you just discuss this topic with your friends or amongst your family members or your peers or your, you know, neighbor people. Just discuss and try to recognize or get the point that why do we call a gentleman, a person, you know, or whom do we call a gentleman? What qualities he should be, he should have to be called as gentleman? These all things are very important, students. So here, discuss in what way these words are an appropriate description for gentleman. So you have to just discuss, try to discuss with your friends or family members. You ask your parent or brother sisters, whom do you call gentleman? Commonly people say a person who is well-dressed, a person who has, you know, like a good manner, a person who is very rich also. Yeah, obviously, when our money comes, we say gentleman. Is it? Because very richest person. Is it? When an actor comes, and we say gentleman because of well-dressed and his popularity. Not only these things, students, we can call a person irrespective of age if he has good qualities. We can daily say he or she is a gentleman. Commonly ladies we say, for female character we say ladies, for male character we say gentleman. So in this story, the story starts with this picture in your textbook, students. Okay, this picture you have in your textbook. These all pictures are there, obviously. But this picture is there in the textbook. So let me start with this picture. And let me write the characters on the board here. The characters of the story: Nicola, Jacopo. So Nicola is 13-year-old. And Jacopo is 12-year-old. And you can see one more important character, that is our author, or you can say the speaker. Okay? A.J. Cronin. And he has his friends also. His friends. His friend is there in the story, name is not given. And one more character is called a car driver. A car driver. He is called Luigi. Okay? He is called Luigi. First important character of the story, these two characters are very much important. That is Nicola, a 13-year-old boy. Nicola, 13-year-old boy, and Jacopo, 12-year-old. These two are brothers. Nicola and Jacopo, these two are brothers. Just 12 and 13-year-old. Very, very young children they are. And the author of the story is A.J. Cronin, who has written the story for you people, and his friend who is in the car, and the car driver. These three characters are very important characters, and rest of the characters I'll let you know later while reading the story. So Nicola and Jacopo, these two figures you can see here. Story starts with this. Okay, this you can see the picture here. This is opening story or opening picture here. So in this story, you can see in the picture you can see these two boys are, you know, one boy is polishing the shoe. One more boy is selling newspapers, and they have fruits and all, many things. You can see many things they are doing here. So this story indicates those two boys work. They what they do, okay? Professionally what they are. Either they are professionally or else they do there for livelihood. So these things you can make out easily in this picture. So let me start the story. As we drove through the foothills of ants. Here V is V. As we draw, V represents the author along with his friends. As I said, you author, his friend, and the car driver. So these three characters he is indicating as three. V. We throw through the foothills of Alps, mountain range. Okay, Alps. Two small boys stop us on outskirts of Verona. Verona. When I see the word called Verona or the name of the city called Verona, something might have strike to you. Yes, students, this name Verona place is very famous place in the world. It is very well known place for even there is one more story called Romeo and Juliet. Yes, Romeo and Juliet, which is written by Shakespeare, the great legend of English literature, Shakespeare, Romeo and Juliet. Yeah, you know Romeo and Juliet, the story is, you know, belong to, or we can say Juliet is belong to the Verona city. Okay, we have studied and you are going to study for second year also Romeo and Juliet, then you come to know where is Verona city and what exactly it is famous for. So here Verona city, it is a place of, it comes in the Italy, in the Italy state, place in the Italy which is very picturesque, is very beautiful, very beautiful place it is Verona. You can go through the YouTube and search how the Verona city looks. Very beautiful, full of greenery and mountains and all. So this Verona city, Verona, it comes in Italy. Okay, Verona city, very beautiful place. These two boys are belong to Verona city. So outskirts of Verona means a ring road, we say outskirts, out of the city, outside. Okay, outskirts of Verona, there were selling wild strawberry, bright scarlet berries, and that looked delicious against the dark green leaves lining with wicker basket. So they were selling wild strawberries. When I say the strawberry word, I think your mouth is watering, right? So strawberries, the strawberries, they were bright berries that look delicious against the dark climbing basket. Here you can see basket. So the basket is like this and it has lines. Through this the berries can be seen easily. So scarlet red color berries are there in the basket. So whoever see or is forced to the basket, their mouth starts to water, friends. Very delicious strawberries there selling. Okay, strawberries they were selling. And here a voice comes, tune by. Somebody says tune by. When the writer, you know, in this picture, you see friends, in this picture, driver, the writer and his friend, these three people are traveling and these two boys are selling the strawberries. And when they say, sir, please purchase the strawberries, sir, we are selling. Then suddenly, when the writer wanted to purchase, when he was about to take, this person, the driver, Luigi, he says, stop, don't buy. Why so? He says, don't buy, warned Luigi, our cautious driver. Writer says that when he was about to purchase, the driver says, don't purchase, wait. Why so, students? Why? The reason? I'll let you know. You'll get fruits much better in Verona. He said, the driver said, sir, don't purchase here. Now, you know, I said already they are outskirts of Verona, okay? Out of the city still. They are, did not enter the city. The writer and his friend did not enter the city. They are outside, okay? So, the driver said, inside the city, in the main city, you will get the better or the best fruits over there, he said. Besides these boys, don't purchase here, sir, he said. He shrugged like this. He shrugged his shoulders to convey his disapproval of their shabby appearance. Shabby appearance, what is this? Ready? Shabby appearance. The boys were not so, you know, they were not looking good friends. I mean, they did not well dressed. They did not dress well. The dresses were, you know, like very old. What they have worn, they were very old and torn one. It shows that they are not obviously they are not rich. It shows that they are not rich. They don't even keep themselves very clean. It shows like that. That's the reason the driver said, sir, don't purchase. Okay, he said, he just shrugged his shoulders like this. And then said that, sir, we can get the strawberries inside the city, in the Varanasi city. Then what happens, you know, students? One boy had an woolen jersey. Why? You know, students, now I want to say about these two boys' dresses. One boy has worn a woolen jersey, stone jersey, and cut off khaki pants. Khaki pants, okay? Khaki color pant or khaki pant. And other stone shortened army tunic. Army tunic means the loose one, okay, which is not fit for the body. Probably somebody has given them. Okay, some commonly we people, you know, I think you people also do the same thing. When you grow tall, when the dress doesn't fit you, then your mama, I think so, your mama, okay, she gives your cloth to somebody else, your housemakers or else the servants or else somebody else, okay, senior. Probably these boys, they have got the dress from somebody else. That's what the second boy, what he has worn? He has worn army tunic, the loose one garment, a loose folds about his skinny frame. Very lean, the boys are very lean. The second boy is very lean. So we can make out, it's very loose and he is like a skinny, very lean. And here H gazing at two little figures. When the writer was, you know, like the boys when they came, so please purchase, sir. When the driver said, sir, don't purchase, sir. Then writer, he was just watching them. When he saw these two boys, he did not listen the driver. He did not listen driver. What he did, you know, he just gazed at two little figures and with their brown skins, tangled hair, the hair also not properly combed, and gazing tangled hair and dark earnest eyes shows us how much they are working, students. Let me tell you, when commonly when you come to college or in school, okay, sometimes you don't have proper food. Sometimes when you study whole day and midnight and so, you'll get your dark circle, okay. Commonly, especially ladies, mama who works in the kitchen, sometimes if she works 24/7, then you know we are dark circle she'll get. Same here, these two boys, you know, they were having dark circles and the eyes, you know, the eyes were like the earnest eyes. It shows us they are very hardworking, they work a lot, they don't give themselves proper time for rest, they don't rest at all. And here, we felt ourselves strangely attracted. Here, we felt ourselves, not only the writer, even his friend. Okay, they were attracted towards the boys. And what happened? My companion spoke to the boys, discovered that they were brothers. He answered, you know, his companion, the writer's friend, he came outside out of the car and talked to those two boys. And then he came to know that these two boys are brothers. Then he said, these two are brothers, sir. Okay, so companion, not writer. Writer was inside the car itself. Companion came, his friend came outside and recognized that or discovered that these two boys are friends. The name of these two boys is Nicola and Jacopo. I repeat, Nicola and Jacopo. I have written here. Nicola, a 13-year-old, and Jacopo, 12-year-old. Younger than yours. Probably you are 15 to 16, am I right? When you enter PU college, 15 to 16, sometimes 17 also. It means younger than you people. 13 and 12, very young, very small students. 13 and 12, and they were selling strawberries. Why so? You can make out easily. See, when you have your parents with you, when your parents give everything to you, then is it any necessary to go and sell something outside? No, students. You will lead your life, happy life. You go to school, you enjoy your childhood and all. Here, it shows that probably these two children, they don't have parent. Is it? That is the reason they are working. When they are working outside, either if their parent are there, mostly they are unable to work properly, or else the money which they are earning, it is not fit for the family, or they are often. Something might be there. I'll let you know in the next session. Okay, don't worry. I'll clear everything. So these two boys are brothers and they are earning their own money in their childhood. Instead of going to school and all, they are earning money. they are focusing on money. So these two boys, when the writer was attracted towards these boys, he just couldn't stop himself, and his companion came outside and asked the name of the boys. One elder name of elder boy name was Nicola, and the younger one was Jacopo, 39, 12 year old. We brought their biggest basket, then set off towards town. It shows that how much humble writer he was. You know, being restricted by the driver, or else being sent by the driver, he didn't listen. Instead of listening, he went in outside and purchased the strawberries. It shows that how much he was, you know, interested, or even he wanted to help the boys. Though their shabby appearance was, you know, like he could make out like these two boys are not so clean and all. Commonly, we people, you know, when we purchase something, we have purpose to be go through the cleanliness. If it is clean, we'll purchase. For us, we don't purchase. When you go to purchase fruits or its vegetables to the market, vendors, first you see whether the person is clean or not. Or else you say, no, Baba, we don't want. But here, the writer, he did not neglect. He purchased a biggest basket of strawberries and went towards the town. Varana is a lovely city, rich in history. Varana is lovely city and rich in history. History means something happened in story, students. Okay, that's what he has given the sentence called history. Before many years, the Varana was very beautiful, very picturesque. That is why he says it's rich in history, very rich in history, which quiet medieval streets of splendid buildings of an exquisite pale honey color. Varana is a lovely city, rich in history, with quiet medieval streets, some splendid buildings, very beautiful, huge buildings like our Bengaluru. Okay, very beautiful building, of an exquisite pale honey color. You know, sometimes some cities they give same color, all the buildings will be the same color. Example, Jaipur. Okay, pink city we call. If you go, you'll just find out there all the buildings, all the shops are same color, pink color. That is why we say pink city, Jaipur. Here, this city was pale honey color. Almost all the buildings were same color. Romeo and Juliet reputed to have lived there. So Romeo and Juliet, we heard that, we have studied also. They were belong to Verona city students. Bombed in the recent war, it has lost its bridges, but not its gaiety or charm. So due to the bomb attack, you know, bomb attack is really worst thing, students. When somebody throw the bomb on a particular state or country, the country will lose its charm, its gaiety, students. Everything will be collapsed. It takes many years together to stand once again, to flourish once again. So here, this once upon a time, this city was bombed. That is the reason. Almost all bridges and all, everything collapsed, destroyed. But still the gaiety is there. Still the beauty is there. Still the beauty we can find in Varana city, though it has, you know, destroyed from the bomb attack. Due to the bomb attack, everything has destroyed. Still we can see the beauty, he says. Because, you know, writer, he has gone to visit the city. When he saw everything, the beauty city, beauty or the picturesque city of Varana, he describes in his story that he said he has written it. Still, see the word, still the gaiety is there, the charm is there. Yes, next. Next morning, coming out of a hotel, writer and his friend and the driver, they were staying in the hotel. Okay, so when they came out of the hotel, we drove up short. Okay, there bent over shoeshine boxes beside the fountain in the public square. So when he came out of the hotel, he saw some people, like few people were there. They gathered and they were getting their shoe polish. Okay, it was too crowded, and it was in the square. Like commonly, when you go supermarket, you can see the square over there. Okay, four rows connected there, or else in the middle, something, a special thing will be there. Let me give the example of our own Timmapalli circle. You can see in the middle, okay, like that only. Here, these two boys, they were polishing the shoe, and it was too cloudy. They were bent over shoe shine boxes. Shoe shine boxes means shoe polishers were there, and the fountain in the public square. Fountain was there, water fountain. Doing a brisk business where our two young friends of previous afternoon. I repeat, doing a bricks business, very busy in the sense, it was too cloudy. This writer was unable to see the boys, but when he came slowly over there, near to the boys, he recognized, see, these two boys. I know him because yesterday I have met him, okay? Anyway, yesterday while coming to the Varanasi city, when he saw these two boys were selling the strawberries, he purchased the strawberries. That's the reason he recognized, he said that, what is it? Doing a brisk business where our two young friends, he said, our two young friends of previous afternoon, it means they were selling the fruits, okay? Whereas today they are shining the shoe. Yesterday they were selling the fruits, today they are shining the shoe, okay? It shows that they are very hard worker. They do many things. We watched for a few moments. Then the trade slackened, means reduced. When the people disappeared from there, when they just went from there, when it was totally, clean, right? When there was slackened, trade reduced, we went over, they greeted us with friendly faces. These two people, like writer and his companion, they went to the boss. The boss said, "Good morning, sir," with very smile on the face, friendly face. "Good morning, sir." Why? Because yesterday they have met, and those two boys came to know this person is too good. Because when the driver said, "Sir, don't purchase the fruits," he purchased the fruits. It shows that this writer is too good person, very kind-hearted person. That is the reason these two boys smiled and said, "Good morning, sir." So they greeted, and they said that, see, I repeat, they greeted us with a friendly face, with very happily, a lovely face they greeted. "Good morning. I thought you picked fruits for Evelyn," I said. Writer said, "I thought you picked fruits for Evelyn, and we do many things, sir." Nicola answered seriously. But the writer said, "I know, I thought you sell the fruits. You sell the fruits and you are doing the polishing the shoe also." Then the answer came from these two boys. Nicola said, the elder boy said that, "Sir, we do many things." With very smiley face to this. "Yes, sir, we do many things." Nicola answered seriously. Seriously. Yeah. So let me tell about these boys. These two boys are own brothers, but Nicola was very serious kind of person. This boy was, very steady smile on his face. This boy, Nicola, very strict, very serious, very often used to laugh. And but Jacopo, he was almost an opposite of Nicola. This was very naughty one. Jacopo was very naughty boy, whereas Nicola was very serious boy. All brothers, just 1 year gap between them. 13 years and 12 years, just 1 year gap between them. But Nicola was very serious. Jacopo was very naughty one. So with his serious face, he said, "Yes, sir, we do many things," he said. He glanced at us hopefully. "Often we show visitors to the town, to the Julius Tomb and other places of interest." So I repeat the sentence. He glanced at us hopefully. Hopefully means, think I'm Jacopo. I'm saying, Nicola, the elder one. "Sir, yes, sir, we do many things, sir." After saying that, I was expecting something from there. Often we go to visitors, okay? We show visitors through the town. We show visitors through town means, as a guide, we work in the city. In this Varanasi city, we work as a guide. Whoever comes to us, a visitor comes, we take them to show the city, Varanasi city, as a guide, okay? Hopefully he was saying, it means he was hoping or expecting even this writer to give the same job to them. or ask, the writer would ask these two birds to show the shooting, the Verona city. So often we show visitors through the town to Julius Storm. I said to students, in this Verona city, Romeo and Juliet, as I said to you, okay? Juliet, Julius Storm is their genius. Okay, we say Samadhi in Kannada language. So, Julius Storm you can see in the Verona city. Yes, students, you open your Google, come to know it is there. I have seen in my classes, offline classes, I have showed this to my children also. Now, but if you just go through the, then you come to know Julius Storm is there in Verona city. These two birds, they work as guide and they show the visitors the city, especially this tomb of Juliet. All right. I smile. You take us along. All right, is okay. And the writer smiled, okay. Wherever you take us, we are ready to come. You can show the city, writer said to the boys. Okay, you take us along this, wherever you take, we are ready. We just come along with you, show the city, he said. As we made the rounds, my interest was again provoked by their remarkable demeanor. See, as we made a round, means this, when the boys were ready to show the city, as a guide, these writer in front and the driver, they were in the car. These two boys were seeing the city, entire Verona city. They started a journey, and when this writer was in the car, you know, he was unable to control himself. He was eager to know, students, why these two boys are working these many things. You know, like first day I saw them selling the strawberries. Second day I saw them, they were shining the show, and now I'm seeing them, they are helping us to show the city as a guide. Why this all work they are doing? So he was very eager to know, students. Common happens when, even you also, let me say you, when you come to know somebody is not doing lot of many jobs, and you know, you'll be eager to know why this. This is human tendency. Commonly we do the same thing. We'll be eager to know many things. So here, this writer was eager to know. My interest was again provoked by their remarkable demeanor. Here, you know, demeanor means what? The way how they communicate, how the children are communicating with the writer, how they are, you know, handling the things very easily, as well as how they were convincing the writer. You know, they convinced the writer very easily. What he said, sir, he said the sentence, I repeat here, hopefully, sir, often we show the visitors the town also. So this shows that the face picture or else the body language of the children shows that even they were attracting the people. They want the people should come to them. They should ask them something, and they were ready very easily. They were available. They were very handy to the people. So here, this demeanor is how they were communicating with the writer. So when they were communicating with the writer was too eager to know the situation, the reason behind them, what they were doing, why they were doing, and why they were doing these all jobs. You know, he was eager to know. So that what he says, it was a remarkable demeanor. They were childish enough, students. Just 12 and 13 year old, yeah, childish enough, and in many ways quite artless. Here, quite artless means they were not professional expert students. Example, a professional expert is different. They were doing many things, but though they were not so expert, but they were good enough. Okay. They were good enough. They were perfect. They were not so perfect in doing all the things, but they were managing themselves to give the best. That is the reason he says that they were quite artless. Jacopo, although his lips were paler than they should have been, paler in the sense here, you know, students, a healthy person, if that person is very healthy, then we can recognize, yeah, he's healthy, he's just mostly he has good food and all. But a person who belongs to a poor, a child who belongs to a poor family, or else he doesn't have any good food, more nutrition we can recognize easily on his lips only. Okay, by seeing the lips only, we can recognize that they are, you know, like suffering with more nutrition, and they are very weak and poor. Same here, Jacopo's, the younger one, lips, they were very pale. By seeing this, the writer recognized that probably something is there behind this story. why these two boys are working like this. So let me know. He was too eager to know. So he was asking many things to them. And he says that his lips are very paler than they have been, was lively as squirrel. Even this boy is too active. This boy was too active before saying that he was ready. Example, see what he used to say, the Jappu naughty boy. Sir, you know, sir, I'm ready to show you this entire city, sir. I know, sir, how to shine the shoes, sir. Do you want somebody, sir? Do you want this, sir? So do you want this, sir? So just tell me, sir, I'll give you. So this is what his style. Very speed he used to speak to the writer. Very naughty and, you know, like very handy he was. So he says that he was very lively as a squirrel. You know, squirrel always, when the squirrel has nut in the mouth, it will be doing like this, like this. When you see the squirrel, when the squirrel will be doing the mouth like this, you think it is mocking, not mocking. Always it eats nuts. So like this, it shows that here this proverb, this phrase means this boy is too active and very energetic to do the things. Very pumped up, always pumping up, always ready to do the things. Nicholas' smile was steady and engaging. Right here, when we see Jokoko as a naughty boy, as when he compares, writer compares him to the squirrel, so active person, very naughty person, whereas Nicola, Jokoko was naughty and Nicola was very steady, very strict on his behavior was very serious students. Let me say, very serious on this example. If somebody says, okay, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Already. I'll be helping, sir. Yes, I'll do it, sir. This is the way. Enough. Very serious. No even smile also. So that's what, you know, Nicola's smile was steady and engaging. Very serious. At in the both these boyish faces, there was a seriousness which one respected. Though these two boys are entirely different, but they work very hard. They do many things. They are always busy in their work. They attract the people very easily. And they are very handy also. They are very useful also. To earn money, they were ready to do the work, students. They were ready to do any work. Any work, not only morning, even at the night also. That is the reason. He says that whoever watch them, they have to respect the boss. They have to salute the boss. He says, which one respected, he gives one a phrase to them, that is what? An air of purpose for beyond their years. Air of purpose, what is this? Air of purpose, we don't know why these two boys are working like this. We don't know why these two boys are doing many things. We don't know why these two boys are behind money. We don't know whether they are saving the money for particular purpose. We don't know whether they have their own plans. We don't know anything. But we know, writer says, we know these two boys are very, you know, active, very energetic. They do many things. What is behind this? What is the reason behind this? We don't know. It is just air of purpose. So, he says that, let me write it here, students, because when the question is asked to you, you are the one who is going to answer. Let me tell you, the boys do many things like, they sell the strawberries or berries, let me say, or the strawberries, they sell the fruits, okay, they sell the fruits. They polish the shoe. They polish shoe. And they are even guide for the tourists who will come to the city, Varanasi city. And when somebody asks, cigarettes, a pack of American cigarettes. Or seat for the opera. or name of any restaurant. I'll just give the list here. Name of a good restaurant. As well as one more name he is given, which is called ravioli. Ravioli, yes. So students, let me clear. Even one more thing, newspaper. This results newspaper. It is there in your next session. Okay, in my next session I'll explain you these all things. But let me give the entire picture here. Students, the children, they sell the fruits. Okay, in the opening picture itself, you can see they sell the fruits. They polish shoes. They polish the shoe of people, other people. If they ask, if the tourist ask any a particular brand over there, a pack of American cigarette, they were ready to bring it. Seats for opera. Opera means the type of dance, students, musical dance. When the writer says, or anybody, any tourist, but here let me use the name as writer, author, because he has written the story, he has met the children, that's what. So when the writer asked, or the author asked the children to get the seats for opera, they were ready. And even when somebody asks them, tell me the good restaurant in Varana city, on tip of tongue they know the names of the restaurants and all. Even there in Varana city, there is a delicious or a very famous meal is there. Okay, a good meal that is called ravioli. It is made up of cheese, students, meat and cheese. Okay, like pasta, we say, or else the fast food, as equal as a fast food, this. So ravioli, it is made up of cheese and meat. Okay, very famous dish of Varanasi city. Whenever anybody else, any time, whatever they ask, the boys were ready to get these all things very easily. And even they used to sell the newspapers. I'll let you know later, students. So these are all works the boys used to do, students. A single person, example, I'm a lecturer. My profession, I just teach and go. Okay, or sometime after going home, I'll do some work, household work. But one person can do one or two things. If at last three things enough. But here, these two boys are doing n number of work. Since day to night, morning to night, even sometimes midnight also they used to do all the works. So that's the reason the writer says that, you know, these two boys were really people, whoever made them, they had respect. They deserve the respect. So one should respect them for their air of purpose for beyond their years, just 13 and 12 years old. That is the reason he says that even the writer also says, I have to respect the boys. In the week which followed, we saw them frequently. In a week means the writer was there for a week in Varanasi city, for they proved that extremely useful to us. The boys proved they were extremely useful to the writer. If we wanted a pack of American cigarette, as I said you, if they want a pack of American cigarette, a seat for opera, a musical dance, as I said already, or name of a good restaurant that could provide them good ravioli, a restaurant where they could get the good food, ravioli, and or else anything, whatever the writer needs, the author needs, the boys were ready to help or get it on the spot. Nicola and Jacopo could be relied upon to satisfy our needs with their usual cheerful competence. With very happily, students, they never showed their anger to anybody else. Whatever the people asked them, whatever, even let me say about the writer only, whatever he asked, they said, "Say, sir, sure, sir. What do you want, sir? We are ready, sir. Yes, sir, I know this one, sir. Yes, I know this one, sir." Just the person has to give the money, and they were ready to do anything else. To earn the money, they were ready to do anything else. In a positive way, not in a negative way. This is what, in my today's session, I tried to cover you people. The story called Gentleman of Verona, just in this first session. In my second session, I'll complete entirely. So today we are talking about writer, as well as these two characters called Nicola and Jacopo. These two boys of the story, two gentlemen of Verona. And tomorrow, in my tomorrow session, I'll tell you, why do we call them gentlemen of Verona, because they were just 12 and 13 year old. And why they used to do these all jobs, okay? What was the reason behind it? Everything I'll let you know tomorrow, students. So until, have a nice day. Goodbye. Take care. Thank you.